Hi guys, I'm Eva and welcome to our Food Forest Cookery channel. Today at my compost corner, everything what the chickens don't like, everything what is too much for the worms, or they don't like it, ends up here. And for this I'm having great compost there, which is coming out underneath, and I show you how easy it is to build. So yeah, let's get into it. So this is the corner of the food forest where we have our fence around, and we have the fence because we don't want the birds getting in and destroy my beautiful veggies and fruits. So yeah, I put metal sheets over there, so it's easier for storage, that nothing doesn't go away. So the next step was to put the, these are not a star pickets, these are actually it's an old scrap metal from a recycling center. I put it on both sides, so both the same, but you could use easily the star pickets as well. They are pretty cheap, and you know, the star pickets for the fencing, what you usually can buy. And yeah, I just put them into the ground and they hold and stay in place. So on both sides, just next to the fence. So the next step was to put two bricks on each side. So here and over there as well. It's not easy to get there, but you will know what I mean. So there are the second bricks as well. So the second lot of bricks. And the next step was just to find a sort of to fence it off. And this was, we also bought it second hand. This is like a pretty solid mesh, and you can buy it in nurseries as well, or like in some sort of warehouse, hardware store and so on, or maybe your recycling center. I just put it into there and secured with these straps. Just two was enough, and you see it sits on the bricks, and the other side is made the same way. And two on each side was enough for me. So of course depends how large is your piece of this mesh, but you need to have access into this goodness, because everything what you throw to the compost, it will rot with the time because the rain comes and so on. And what you get, it's the best compost you can have. So you see, so if I need really, really good compost, I just grab, of course, usually with my gloves, but I just want to give you the idea. This is what comes out. After a while, depends of course on the temperature, on the outside temperature, and depends what you put in, but I'm really putting everything in. And yeah, if it's very dry, you can like sprinkle it, but just the rain what we've got, I haven't done anything into it. And I lost of course some seeds again, like tomatoes and the Malabar spinach here. And the rosellas are going crazy, which are growing next to the compost. Oh, they are already, look, they are already seeds, so they will grow the new ones. But yeah, the Malabar spinach going crazy because it's got great soil here. So it grows mad. It goes actually there. And up here already. So we can pick it as well. And I lost some tomato seeds or tomatoes here. And that's why we have the beautiful tomatoes now growing. And if you tie them up, you've got a nice support for them as well. So here we are. Beautiful tomatoes going up there. And also I threw a little cutting of cassava, which I was thinking it won't grow, but actually it started to grow, so I will have cassavas here underneath as well. So yeah, everything going really good. And you can see it's just everything in there. So when I remove something, some weeds or whatever, so I just throw it in and forget about it. You can put some cardboard in between as well sometimes, but my worms are getting the cardboard, so it's no need. Just anything from your garden, anything. And that's pretty much it. So this is the compost corner. You can make it larger, you can make it smaller, whatever suits your needs. But that's the idea of it. I hope you really like it, because it's, yeah, it makes, as I said, it makes lots and lots of sense. So when you look at the, when you look at the compost, so it makes lots of sense, and it will make your garden happy. So yeah, I hope you liked this video, and if you did, put a thumb up for me or subscribe and let me know your comments. And I would love some comments to see what you think about it. And yeah, hope to see you next time. So thanks a lot, guys. Bye.